What's up, everybody? This video is a segment taken from a livestream painting that I did, where I took a break from the painting and started to read from my journals that I had written from my time in the jungle. And so it describes some ayahuasca experiences of mine, and I've just added in some illustrations and animations to help show what it is I'm talking about. So I hope you enjoy the video.
I begin to see a slow buildup of shapes and patterns around me, glowing orbs of light floating up into my visions. I see snake scales uncoil out of the darkness, signifying the entry into the shamanic dimension. And so those visions start to subside and entering these visions of many luminescent orbs flowing through the scales of the snake. And then one opens as if it's the snake eye within these luminescent yellow orbs, and I begin to enter closer to the same blue light which I had seen in a previous ceremony, but it didn't really go much further, and it was moving beyond these kind of bluish vines in front of this emanating blue glow further in the distance. And as I come closer to this blue source, I hear a voice that says, "We are calling to you," the voice says. And I'm presented with glowing blue figures amongst a dark environment, which is actually what I'm depicting in this painting. Everything is a little dim and a little blurry, and the figures are saying telepathically, not through spoken words, that they are always calling to me, that I've not been listening, not been paying attention to them. There are more of them now in a small group all together facing me. They tell me they are spirits responsible for my beating heart. I live because they desire me to live. I must open myself up to them and listen to what it is they wish to share with me. The blue figures fade into the distance as the darkness grows and pulls them further away from me. These spirits had an impression of royalty. They wore crown-like structures that looked very much a part of their organic form, rather than something that is separate to them. I feel movement is in me as if I am being carried. Visions appear where it looks like I am traveling through star fields, celestial spaces, going ever onwards. Into this infinite space, there is a size and vastness to the cosmos that I'm experiencing here, one that I never really truly think about in every waking day life. But here it is with me right now, and I'm contemplating the utter enormity of it, alone in space. And I'm back on the Earth sensing... Oh, so I've been in the cosmos at this point, and I'm back on Earth sensing the life in the environment around me in this very moment, and sensing how we are all, the planet itself, situated in space in the cosmos. That is not something separate from us, but it is all here within us. There is a stream of spirits above me in my vision. So this is not really happening at all with like eyes open, but when I sort of close my eyes, you get the sense of this overlapping layer of reality that you are looking in on. And as I've gone through in later ceremonies, this is kind of the vision of the pineal gland, the third eye. So I'm witnessing the stream of spirits coming right overhead. Yeah, it's like individual life of each ethereal spirit moving in this stream. They all continue on without noticing me for a long time, until I sense a strong familiar energy to one of these spirits, who becomes alerted by my focused attention on it. But as it comes over, this mass of energy forms into a focal point, a little like a face, but with no distinguishable humanoid features. I feel its consciousness, and it's something that feels very much separate from me. It's like not something that is from within, but very much like an outside spirit. And I feel that conscious element of it focusing on me very intensely, a very strong sensation of being observed. From the intense observation of this spirit, more visions start to well up. Various different psychedelic and geometric images, patterns playing out in glowing plant life, lots of organic mass. But within each of these visions, it feels like there is an intruder to them, and it is this same kind of spirit that has been observing me. And I feel this presence enter into each of these separate visions and almost play and manipulate with the visions that are being generated from my own psyche. The presence moves through the vision, and the visions react to this. This presence has no form, so to speak, but instead creates its form out of the elements of each vision. So it's as if the visionary experiences I'm going through are kind of wrapping around this form of a spirit. Almost as if this vision is entity is following me through each of these visions, trying to catch up with me, and I sense a playful energy from it as it enjoys the game of playing with my different visions. Eventually, one of the visions looks like a plant under the lens of a microscope, very colourful, seeing all the little intricate details of plant life matter. The elements of the vision, again, are under the manipulation of this presence, and it makes a embracing action, like a hug, of the vision around me, and my view fills with light until the vision has completely disappeared in a white glow. There are no visions now, but I feel this presence of the entity very strongly now. And all I experience now is a voice saying the most simplest of words, just saying hello, very excitedly. And there's a little back and forth between here that I've written out, and I'm sort of asking if right now it's within me, and my hand is over my chest where I entered, and there is, I get this vision of a great light source from within, kind of emanating from this, and I see kind of like glows come through the fingertips. And it's describing to me that yes, it is within me and it sees everything. It sees all my memories and just contemplates that I've seen many interesting places and how calm it is in here within me. And from that, I see the entity take its visual form again as it exits out of me and twirling around in this constantly changing mass of pink colored energy, dancing and spiraling around. At this point, I'm like, fascinated by the encounter. I'd like to continue with it more. And it rushes back within me as I say this and transforms from its unformed massive energy into something that represents a great blazing phoenix bird. Its energy much more intense than before. Where before it felt like a young, playful spirit, now it feels quite powerful, telling me it would be an honor. And it goes on to describe that it was a certain missing part of myself, like a part of my soul that had been lost long ago in childhood. At this point, and it kind of nestles into my heart as well, kind of like looking in on itself as like a little bird perched in my heart space. And at this point, I'm aware of Scott, who's the facilitator. I haven't been aware of the outside world for long, and he puts his hand on my chest as if checking my heartbeat pulse. And it's quite synchronistic that he should do this just as the spirit enters my own heart. And I'm kind of musing that I haven't kind of moved a muscle at this point because I'm just lying back, just allowing this to happen. So he's probably just checking on me to make sure I'm all right. That's the end of that particular chapter in the experience. But let me go on to talk about a little more about another experience as well. Out of the darkness, this vision of a flower unravels to reveal its bright glowing core. And when the flower has fully unraveled, the entire area surrounding me and the flower itself erupts into visions, entering a plant-like kingdom of visions. There's this central shaft or core rotating around, glowing orbs embedded in it like jewels, many vines growing out of it as it rotates. And I see a field of many flowers open up in front of me, holding golden writing along the edges of the leaves, kind of similar to how I've been trying to depict here, this golden sacred language almost. Each of these flower heads with this sacred writing on, rotating and kind of rocking side to side. And when each of these plants blooms with the writing inside, I feel a great intelligence come from these plants, and they are being very generous, very welcoming to learn from the plants. It's something I've had come up in a few ayahuasca ceremonies of mine, and shaman will often talk about this as well. The more they work with the ayahuasca and the different plants, the rare spirits of the plants actually open up to them because they want the shaman to learn about the various different healing properties, because each plant within the jungle has a very distinct personality and spirit. They all have something to teach. Oh, and they're asking me to walk the shamanic path with them in this one in particular. The leaves start to peel off at the edges. Oh yeah, the sacred hieroglyphics peel off the edges of the flowers and encompass all around me. The symbols entering into me and filling up my entire vision. And I have visions of many plant petals unfolding, all with joyous Buddha faces on them. And I'm getting messages to love more and be more open. At this point, I'm going through tunnels and vortexes of psychedelic experience within this plant dimension. At the bottom of this wormhole slash vortex is a kind of a large insect or a critter, a praying mantis. Its front antenna probing me and dancing around my head as if analyzing me. And coming through, it's also like seeing that as a kind of gatekeeper, and it's coming through the other side of that. I see a break within this heavily dense visions of organic plant life, and I enter into this huge expanse of a great blue sky above fluffy clouds. It's like I've reached the very top of the plant kingdom, and I see the outer rim of the plant kingdom still as it gives way to this great expanse. Great towering plant structures are still seen, holding intricate patterns within them. Small little bulb-like plants with these little helicopter tops are floating up out of the plant kingdom into this great expanse of the sky, and I hear a voice within telling me the kingdom of heaven lies within. My mind occupies a space slightly above my entire lifetime path, where I can see everything in my life all together at once. Things that felt insignificant at the time now show clearly as important waymarkers on my path to this point. This overriding sense of fate. For what reason and to where this was leading, I wasn't certain, but I could see something in the far reaches beyond, some piece of energy that had a very ancient remembrance to. It was hard to place exactly what it was, but there was a certainty of something there. So I think that is hinting at something pulling me on this path. Okay, I'm going to read this last bit, which is me coming back to the treehouse that I was staying in whilst I was in the jungle. So coming back into my treehouse after the ceremony, I feel a second wave of the medicine hit me. I sit on the bed in above the canopy in my treehouse, overwhelmed by the sounds and energies of the canopy. I visually see the energy of the jungle being drawn into the top of my head. Colors and patterns of the jungle being drawn into me. I see photographic image-like images of the jungle, fragmented into sheets of mirrors that hold parts of the jungle image. The tip of my head glows white and opens up. There is no separation between my mind, or my head, and the outside energies. A crown of plants erupts from my head, and orbs of light float out of it. The individual plant leaves swaying back and forth. There is a great sense of clean energy in the environment around me. I can see how being in this environment is healing to our own inner landscape. What we experience in the outside world is all happening within our own minds. We have this inner state within us at all times that is built up and created out of our outward experiences. And the more beauty we can experience outwardly, the more beautiful it appears inwards. The places we go, people we interact with, it all gets added to this inner landscape I've written. So coming here in the jungle and being able to take away a piece of the jungle and its abundant source of energy is very beneficial to this inner landscape of ours. I could see how the energy of working in an industrial modern culture was not healthy. People's collective traumas condensed very heavily into this geographical area that creates a traumatized societal structure, and through us interacting with it causes us to absorb some of that trauma. I could feel all this energy of the jungle being drawn in and added to my inner realm. Just to be here was in a sense like an antibiotic to some of the less desirable parts of our inner landscape created through various experiences in our lives. Being here in the jungle, I was absorbing the natural pulse and vibration of the jungle energy, able to admit that positive vibration it gave me. So that is the a small piece of my journals with ayahuasca. I hope that didn't sound overly pretentious.